it's Amaranth, and you can call me Robin, and today we are continuing our week 3 exploration into ATs by getting into some of their pre-debut stuff. Anyways, we are getting into some of ATs' pre-debut stuff, including like all of their KQ Fellas dance videos, and as well as the cover of Growl that they have from EXO. Now, I will say that I know for a fact that I have seen at least the first performance video. I know I talked about that before. I didn't realize at the time that I saw it, like, that it was ATs. If that makes sense. Like, I saw it, like, when, like, around the time that it came out, and so I didn't realize, like, after that it was the same as ATs, because they went by KQ Fellas at the time. I don't, like, now it says ATs on the video title, but I don't know if it always did, so a little confused about that. But I know that was, like, their pre-debut name. But anyways, I'm excited to get into it. I'm excited to just sit and be amazed by their amazing talent. Talent? I guess that's a new word for dance talent. Talent. I mean, sure. Let's go with it. Let's not. Actually, let's pretend that didn't happen. Anyways, I'm excited to be amazed by their dance talent and just be wowed and in awe and in shock. So I'm actually going to start with their cover of Growl, because I freaking love that song, and I didn't know that they did a cover of it until like a couple minutes ago, and I was like pulling up a playlist of all their pre-debut stuff, and I'm like, oh, I need to see that right now, like right now. So we're gonna start with that, and then we're gonna get into the performance videos. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into it. And also, if you missed my other videos in my ATs exploration series, I don't want to keep talking about it every time in the intro, or else these intros are gonna be very long, but all of it's in a playlist up there, so you can go ahead and watch that. But all right, let's get into Growl.
Yo. Okay.
I don't remember, like, the sexy whispers. Maybe that's just me. They have a really interesting formation going. They don't have the same amount of members. That was cool, how it came from the back. Well, that was super cool. I don't have much to say about it because it's a cover, so I mean, it's not like I can comment on the song or whatever, but that was really good. And I like again, they did like really interesting formations with the amount of members that they had. Yeah, that was awesome. Now let's get into their performance videos.
Hey, yo, big bro, you fucking with that?
Okay, cool.
Why was he doing push-ups? Oh my god.
I know you like this beat too, but you a fucking goofy though. Huh? Oh wait, what? Word around town. I heard this boy was a clown.
Swimming your bitch once I drown.
Call up my plug for the pounds. Wait, our future years right on my clothes. Bad bitch, yeah, watch it do cold. Broke a sale, use
the store.
I never do it no more. Selling you broke is no joke. Ooh, I used to kick in that dope. Wait, now I'm selling all the shows. While I'm all rich, then you right on my
clothes. It looks like they're having so much fun. It's so cool.
A bad bitch, Puerto Rico.
Get her out, Molly, she geeking. Call me a free every shit for the week. And next time, you know what I'm saying?
I think that's the thing about ATEEZ too, is that like anytime you see them dance, like they look like they're so wholeheartedly enjoying what they do. Even like some people like can like start, I don't know how to explain it better, but like some people either like can like grimace or like not smile as much when they're dancing, or like they're too focused on like the actual like movements to like really enjoy it. But like every time ATEEZ dances, like they really, you can see how much they are enjoying what they're doing on their faces, and it doesn't feel like it's just, you know, like a smile they put on for like show or performance. Like it seems like they truly like are having fun dancing. So that's why it's so good to watch them. So let's get into the second one. Woo! Woo, that look!
Looking like a quarter lick. Lick. Run up on me, you get hit. And all my bitches with the shit. Don't New York case a bitch. Looking like a quarter lick.
That's like such a professional dance group.
Since they wanna bend that bitch. Since they wanna bend that
bitch.
Ooh, that looks
cool.
Got some hitters.
Love that. That was a way to end it. Oh my god. Wow. Okay. That was a way to end it. I love the little squad at the end. Wow. I was gonna say something at the end, and then I like squatted and I lost my train of thought completely. Oh, I was gonna say, how I said, like, they look like a really professional dance crew. I've watched a lot of people, like, as I said, I've been just being smothered in ATEEZ, but it's great, I love it. And so, like, when I'm not, like, watching Holla Holla, I'm watching people react to Holla Holla, or then I'm listening to Holla Holla, like, I can't stop listening to that song. But anyways, I've heard a lot of people say, like, oh, they look like, why do they even bother singing? Like, they can just dance. And I'm like, well, I feel like, you know, the great thing about ATEEZ is that they can dance well enough to be, like, a standalone, like, you know, just dance group, but the fact that they also make songs, and they make songs that fit the type of dance that they want to do, like, if they just dance, like, yeah, these songs are great, but it's, like, it's not, like, the fact that they're dancing to their own songs makes it even that much better, if that makes sense. But anyways, let's get into the third one. Wow. Ooh, I love how as one they were moving. Felt like a single being, even though they were doing different stuff. Ooh. Bang. Woo. I thought they were switching so like seamlessly back and forth between dancing to like the actual beat and the melody. You have to pick up the beat when it matters. Woo. Ooh, that was very impressive. That was really impressive. All right, the next one is Yoonho's solo. And I'm not, like, purposely trying to stop and comment on all of these, like, as I finish, but, like, every time it finishes, I'm like, oh, I have things to say about that. But it's, like, the way, and I would say I'm a professional dancer, but I do watch a lot of dance content, and at one point in time, I did dance as a child, so hey, I feel entitled to talk about this a little bit. But the way that they kind of, like, fluidly move between, like, really controlled, like, ticking, like, as you saw at the end of that last video, and then kind of go straight back into, like, the kind of, you know, kind of, like, groove move, if that makes sense. Why am I saying groove move? I sound like an 8-year-old talking about this. Anyways, like, the way they go from, like, such strong, like, you know, isolated movements into like a bounce or something is so, like, it's so fluid that it feels so like, what's the word I'm looking for, it feels so satisfying to, like, watch them dance because they do that so fluidly. But anyways, let's get into Yoonho's solo. Here we go.
I'm in love with the go-go. Ride through the city with a check on me. Ride through the hood with a tech on me. 28 make a double. I ain't never trying to cuddle. So explain why these motherfuckers slept on me. 8 ball till I reach me a kilo. Made enough, then I went to see Rico. Paid a fool if you're acting like Rico. I'ma tie him up, tape his ass like Nico. 100 real clip in the motherfucking set. Catch a hot 9-7 if his ass wanna flex. High school, got up on a nigga with the robber. 12K, put my pistol in a fucking dishwasher. One hit wonder. Yeah, that's a fact. Hit his ass to the police, wonder where I'm at. Make so much money off this goddamn song. Still get in your ass like a goddamn thong. Cocoa Puffs, yeah, that's for the kids. Stop trying to act like you don't know what it is. Bacon soda ain't cut me no check. If they don't, I'ma show them motherfuckers what an Arm & Hammer is. Everybody know I'm in love with the coke. My ass pissed to the young nigga for a joke. If a nigga got a problem, then he gon' get smoked. I'ma squeeze and I'm out like a punk too close. I'm in love with the coke. I'm in love with the coke. I got it for the lolo. Turn up. I'm in love with the coke.
That was great. I'm glad that they gave him a solo to kind of shine for a minute there. All right, that was all of their pre-debut stuff for the most part. All right, so that was some of their pre-debut stuff. I can definitely see why, like, and I was, you know, like, into K-pop and, like, around on the internet when they were, you know, uploading that stuff and when it kind of, like, spread like wildfire everywhere. And I did, like, I can totally see, like, why, so many people were like, oh my god, you need to see this, like, it really is impressive, and again, it's that kind of thing where it's like, okay, if they can do that on, like, someone else's song, like, what can they do on their own song, you know? So I think it was really smart to, like, release all that stuff before they actually debuted, and then it was just like, hey, here's this really cool group that can dance really well, and they'll wait to see what they can do with their own music, and it's just like, oh, wow. This is amazing. Stan. But yeah, so that was me checking that out. Hopefully you guys enjoy. If you did, leave a like, subscribe for more, leave me recommendations down below on what other ATEEZ content I should check out, and I will see you all next week in week 4. Bye-bye.